Almost every time we go into an existing facility to build a clean room, we face challenges and limitations. I'm going to show you some of those limitations today and how we work through those and make sure we have a facility for our client at the end that works for them. My name is Colin Kemp, ProPharma Cleanrooms, project manager. Let's take a walk and let me show you how we're going to do this. In this room, we're currently in phase one of construction. In this facility, we're facing gypboard wall here, and this is existing structure. So we're going to come in and the room's basically going to be in a white box. We're going to take our 1/4-inch honeycomb aluminum panel with baked enamel finish, and we're going to glue it onto this wall and then attach it in the middle with a strip. And what we're going to be able to do is seal both sides of that with 100% silicone, and it's going to meet USP standards for the surface of how it has to be. Above me, when this phase is complete, there will be ductwork will be done, electrical rough ends will be done by the general contractor. And we're going to come in and we're going to install our ceiling grid at 7 foot 10 inches high. And the reason we're going to do it at 7 foot 10 inches high is to have less space for cleanable air that has to be cleaned. And it's also going to make it easier for the staff to clean the ceilings that is going to have to be done once a month, giving them a more easily cleaned environment. If you come this way, you can see that we have a wall chase right here. And we designed these in our walls. Instead of having to cut holes into our panels, we're able to run our electrical conduit down the wall, cap it off, and silicone it very nicely to the wall so it meets USP standards. Right here, we've installed our pass-through. And the cool thing about these pass-throughs is they're interlocking. So with that being said, when you open this door and you place your medicine here, you're not able to get it out of the other side of that until this is closed and locked again. And that helps with the cleanability of this air from negative and positive going back and forth between each other. Before we come in, we've got a checklist that we send to the general contractor, and it basically specifies what we need before ProPharma's scope of the project can start. As you can see on these prints right here, we're given a massive facility and we're only one little piece of this facility. So there's a lot of things that come into play when we're planning and designing our scope, and very much when we're building our scope. And that's why we're going to come out and we're going to do a site visit and actually check the dimensions of the white box that you have provided us, the ductwork that has been provided for us, the electrical rough ends, because it's very important that the right power, the right air flows, and everything is going to the proper equipment that we're going to spec. Follow me, we're going to check out phase two. We're going to walk in here. As you can see, this wave plate right here is designed so you can go in and out of the rooms without dirtying up your hands or any of the equipment in the room, which is a very important piece of this. We have our ceiling grid in, our lights just dropped, our HEPA's dropped, and now we're going to go through the details of what phase two means. So our ceiling's set at 7 foot 10. These lights are actually clean room grade lights, meaning that they are very smooth, and they have a gasket sitting in the ceiling grid that actually seals these lights down to meet USP standard. These clean room tiles are actually a clean room grade tile, which is also meaning that it is a very smooth surface, easily cleanable, and they are also siliconed down to the ceiling grid throughout this project. This is a MAC 10 HEPA filter. If you take a look right here, this would be called a challenge port. And the purpose of this challenge port is so the certifier can hook up an aerosol test to it and actually test that HEPA filter and see how it's doing, see if there's any leaks or anything like that in it without having to cut the ceiling tile out and go above ceiling, which would cause the room to become uncertified or dirty at that point. And now you can see these windows. We've seen a lot of end user groups like to have these windows so they can see the work going on inside of the space, actually from outside of the space, not being gowned and garbed. One of the nice details about our windows is this ledge right here. You know, you don't ever want to see a big nasty ledge in a clean room that could collect a lot of dirt or dust. So what we've come up with in our design is we've now got this nice slanted ledge. It's very easily cleanable. And right here is going back to the electrical chase you saw in phase one. It's now getting a little closer to completion. This is where your conduit for any equipment that's going to show up later in this phase, your hoods, your pumps, anything that you're going to have for monitors and things like that, this is where all of your electrical would go. And we're actually going to be able to seal this off and make it very nice and cleanable for the client. Here you can see we have a low wall return, or it could be an exhaust in some situations. And these are strategically placed across the project depending on what equipment is going to go into this project. And what we're doing here with these low air returns is we're actually bringing clean air from the ceiling of the room in the top of the space, making a sweep across the room back into this return, recycling it, going back into the room. You could really notice the level of detail that we put into this caulking. It's 100% silicone. And the reason behind that is when we leave here and the end user is using this space, they're going to be required per USP to have a very stringent cleaning protocol that's going to have some harsh chemicals in it. We have now determined that this silicone that we use can last up to 17 years up against those harsh chemicals that we use. We're known for being able to come in and be handed a very complex environment with a lot of limitations and be able to work hand in hand with the general contractor, the architect, or the end user to develop a functional facility that meets the needs of the pharmacy staff and ultimately the patient.